Hare Krishna. Heart work is hard work. Sometimes people think of hard work in terms of physical hard work, or lift a lot of baggage, a lot of weight, or go and do a heavy workout. Of course, nowadays we also understand that because we work in the intellectual field quite a bit, maybe we do data analysis, we do coding, that also requires hard work. So there can be different kinds of hard works, but there's one kind of hard work which we often don't recognize, that is heart work. Heart work, what does it mean? It means we work on our heart and we work to offer our heart to another. In our heart, there are various kinds of desires. Some are healthy, some are unhealthy. We need to nourish and manifest our healthy desires, and we need to starve and eliminate our unhealthy desires. And quite often these unhealthy desires are very strong, and fighting them back requires energy. We have worldly attachments which pull our consciousness in particular directions, and pulling back, not letting the consciousness go in that direction, requires an enormous amount of hard work. So when we try to practice bhakti yoga, we are trying to offer our heart to Krishna. And when we try to offer the heart to Krishna, at that time the heart, because of its own conditionings, because of its own attachments, wants to go off in other directions. So to get the heart to go towards Krishna is not easy. It requires the persistent effort. Now, normally, wherever our mind is, that's where our heart gets invested sooner or later. And whatever is in our heart, that's where our mind goes. So heart can refer to the seat of emotions. Mind refers to the point from which most the impressions, the place where our impressions are stored, from which most of our emotions are triggered. So if we are very attached to, say, sports, to cricket, to watching cricket, say, then our thoughts will constantly be going towards cricket again and again and again. And if somebody is attached to alcohol, their thoughts will again and again go to alcohol. So now if they want to redirect their heart to elsewhere, that's not easy. In the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, sanishchayena yogtavyo yogo anirvinna chetasaha sankalpa prabhavan kamams tyaktva sarvana sheshataha manasaivendriya gramam vinyamya samantataha. In 6.24 in the Bhagavad Gita, he says, sanishchayena yogtavyo, with great determination we need to work. Yogo anirvinna chetasa, that in the practavath of yoga, without letting our consciousness get distracted. Anirvinna chetasa, sankalpa prabhavan kamams, there will be various kind of desires which will come up within us, and these desires will impel us towards certain kind of actions. I want this, I like it, I must get it. Tyaktva sarvana sheshataha, we need to give them up. And then sanishchayena yoktavyo, with determination we have to engage. And yogo anirvinna chetasa, without getting disheartened. Now when do we require determination? When do we need to give up disheartenment? That is most of the time when something requires persistent effort that can be demanding. So just as the relationship with Krishna is hard work, because we want to focus on Krishna when our consciousness wants to go here and there. Similarly, any kind of relationship, if we are trying to offer our heart to someone, it is hard work. It requires effort. And by recognizing that it requires effort, just as we know when we are going to go for a workout, it's going to require effort. If you are going to go to take a difficult exam, we know it requires work. Similarly, when we understand that developing a relationship, especially developing the supreme relationship, will require work. Just as the relation workout, when it is done, we feel so much stronger and better. When the exam is cracked, then we have such a brighter career ahead of us. Similarly, when the relationship is nourished, especially our relationship with Krishna is nourished, so much fulfillment there. So the hard work has rich fruits, but still it is hard work. By knowing that the hard work is hard work, we can gird ourselves to determinedly practice the process of purification by fixing the mind in Krishna wherever it wanders, and therein we will experience the supreme enrichment through steady purification. Thank you.
Hare Krishna.